at the end. So it's gonna be interesting trying this out. I haven't played a small map, a mountainous map, or a harsh climate before at all. So it's kind of going and trying something totally different that I'm used to. The space is really small in here, but it's a decent seed I got, so it should be fine, I guess. I hope. Hey, well, she late because of my internet's terrible. Well, a raid is never late. You're just a right on time, always. Gentleman is never late. He comes at exactly right time. Let's see. My wife is laughing there. And I know because I know what she's thinking with her dirty mind. Seems I'm out of fuel. So let's clear cut this area totally. I guess so, Ned. Transcoding on. Thanks a lot, Trashlock. Transcoding is the best thing ever you can give to someone else when you raid. Because having transcoding helps a lot. Because a lot of people still have a not so good internet. So giving the option for lower quality is really, really nice thing. I'm really good both ways. I actually slept very well today. For some reason, maybe because I stopped streaming before 6 a.m. yesterday. It's gonna be also today. I'm not gonna go that late because I need to be in good spirits and have energy for tomorrow if I'm gonna marathon the Castlevania. I haven't tried it, Night Basilisk, but all the night dev stuff is kind of. I'm not sure if I'm gonna touch those. For some reason they feel kinda strange. I'm using the denotifier myself. I just got the 1 month subscription to try it out, but for what I've been trying it out, it looks pretty good. We don't need no transcode, I want the raw deal. Well, Barbaris, if we had a transcoding every day, if there was enough viewers, plus 50, or a partnership, I could bump up my. Thanks to Bolt for the follow. I could bump up my quality higher, so we could watch a bit higher quality. Yeah, Rocky Rods. Three streams and Eve, it's kinda bad. So if there was a transcoding or a partner constantly, I could do like 3000 bitrate streaming constantly. Let's unpause this hunting cabin. So we didn't die during the first year. That's good. The night they wanna run the integrates. You can integrate this one also, the denotifier, Night Basilisk. Only $99 per centimeter of Bell's hair. Get yours now. It's my hair. I'm not gonna give it to you. Or to any donation. I like my long hair. Thanks, Bemol with soul. My wife is saying that I could sell spare hair. We have a gold mine of those on the floor every day. But when you have a long hair. Thanks, Sodi, again. When you have a long hair, it's always everywhere. Yes, Keymaster, we are doing this challenge achievement to build on a really small mountainous map. In here, this is basically the whole map you see here, and there's huge mountains in the way still, so it's kind of annoying. So it's only one more building to be done. Let's see. Let's get a couple more foresters. Your streaming has to expand. Yeah. Used Witch Arts. Yeah, Nahku, I've been using that one too, but it's not the best, to be honest. It's a really buggy software, and I had a lot of issues with getting it running. So I wanted to try out something else, and this denotifier works really well, and don't have to have any fuss with it. Just open it in a Chrome window or Firefox. I use Firefox for all my other browsing, so I just added it to my Chrome window, and it works really well from there without having to deal with another program or anything. Let's see. So we have a gathering ball here. We have a 2,000 food coming from here, and we have about 600 food coming from the field. So it means we cannot even feed the current population with the current food. So we need another source of food as soon as possible, and I don't know where to put it and what it should be. Another farm, maybe. Just let's cut this area out. Yes, you can, Nahku. Although I didn't figure out yet how to add a picture there, but you can change the color and the font and all that size, and where it pop. I mean, does it come from top or down or whatever? You can also use custom CSS for that, which I don't know how to use, but I imagine you could do a lot of stuff with that. And you can somehow add pictures there also, but I didn't have time or knowledge to do it yet, because I just set this up a moment ago before I started streaming. Yeah, the third picture definitely helps in that hair collection of Nightquist. Although I still like the first one the most. Oh yeah, we also have the hunter coming soon, so that adds a bit more food. But it's not enough. I'm gonna add a gatherer's hut in here. Building all these houses early on may have not been the best idea, because it did add a bunch of children. So let's make the gatherer in there. It's not the best gatherer, to be honest. It can actually be a bit closer due to that, although it will... Where is the other gatherer? It's gonna be overlapping, and overlapping is not good. So I'm not gonna put it there, actually. I think I'll... I don't know. Let's do the farm. It's the better option. Also, we can start doing pumpkins immediately and don't have to wait anything. Maybe I should make a hunter here also, to kill these animals. I need to bridge this, get a trading post there, and maybe a fishery. Let's do a fishery there. It's not the best spot, to be honest though. Still a fishery. And we need a house. In there. Let's pause that one. Hopefully that helps night puzzles. Gets really annoying when the buffering happens. Yeah, it doesn't really, night puzzles, but some people have really, really bad connections. And they do need the lower qualities. Even the 2000 bit rate I'm using is a bit too much for some people. So it's good always to have a at least an option for those people also to watch. I'm running out of manpower. That's not good. Let's look at this hunting cabin, how well it does, and also this gatherer's hut there, and this farm. I'm actually quite interested to see how well all of these do each year. Buffer is the same, yeah. That kinda sucks. So this farm will not do anything during this year. Let's get the... Thanks, Fedexico, for the follow. I need a tailor and a... Tailor and a... Blacksmith. I'm gonna wait for this to be removed, and I'll have the tailor and the other one just here. Hey, hello. Storage is almost full. Strange. Oh yeah, we are cutting so many trees there, and there's a bunch of stuff there. Let's make another stockpile, just there maybe. Well, there. No, hello. I just wanted to do this Mountain Man achievement challenge today. The other city is doing just fine. 900 plus population, about 80 years into the game, so it's doing pretty well. But there is this achievement for the mountain men to use harsh climate on a small mountain map. So I wanted to do this one today. I miss Thor and Tour. Yeah. Tour the student and Tour the miner in the previous city. Well, there's probably gonna be some interestingly named people in this city also. So there is some venison coming. Potatoes. I should be fine for this year. Maybe the next year is gonna be where I need more food from there. Can I actually get the road away from there at all? I can do something like that. And we can add the blacksmith and the tailor. Well, there's a spot in middle. That's okay. I'm not sure, Elo. I think it's gonna be a bit difficult. Because the space is so limited in this one. I mean, this is the whole map, so there's a lot of mountains here. So I can use a bit of area there, this riverside here, a bit there. This is already used pretty much. There is a small area there, then there is this wooded corridor going up here. And all those trees are useless. And there's a bit of area just here, maybe. And there, I guess. And the starting location here. So there is not much space at all. Yeah, it is super small. So it's gonna be interesting. But it's only 50 people, and we are already at 36 people. So what might be the downfall? Not enough food, not enough firewood are definitely the worst ones. Tools are gonna be difficult, and having enough warm clothing is gonna be also the ones. But I don't know, I should be fine. I mean, getting to 50 is fairly easy. I need only 14 more and we are there. So a couple more houses there, like at the edge there, and getting all the food production. I'm doing another field now. Hey Rushlock, thanks a lot for the raid. It was a really, really amazing raid. So, thank you for that. There was snow already in the autumn. So the harsh climate is the one that is gonna be really annoying. the size of the map and the mountain is just gonna be limiting my space where I can build. But the harsh climate is the one to look for, because you get snow and minus degrees already in the autumn. So that means your crops will die early on, because the snow comes. And also it's gonna get really cold during the winter. So you need warm clothing, you need firewood, and you need houses, or your people will die from freezing and starvation. I should be almost fine. I mean, this one will do about 1,500 food. This one does, okay, we can see, about 500 per year. So this is about 2,000 food. The gatherer's hut here does about 2,000 food. This one does, well, it's a first year now, so it does about 500 in total, so 4,500 food in there. The fishery, maybe 500 to 1,000 if it is well running well enough. So this should be almost 5,000 food in total now. Which means 50 people can live off those, because you need 100 food per person on average per year. So just running these current food production is enough for the 50 people in this map. I'm trying to get about 70 to 80 people maybe in total, because there might be some issues, like a small starvation spiral, or I don't know what else can really happen, because I have the disaster zone, or well, people may freeze or whatever. So I want to have at least a small buffer zone there of 20 to 30 people, so if like 10 people die, I'm not gonna lose the achievement run. I mean, I just have to start the 20 years again, so I need to have at least 50 for 20 years in a row. So I don't wanna suddenly dip under the 50 due to people dying. And start the 20 year counter again. Because 20 years is a decently long period. But I have the disasters off at the moment, because that is not required for the achievement. So there is not gonna be tornadoes or fires. I don't think there's gonna be diseases or infestations also. So it should be fine. As long as I don't screw things on my own by not having houses, food, firewood and all these tools and everything, it should be fine. Like, reserve of food is low. And that is not good. Yeah, early winter and minus 12. That's kind of bad. Although the firewood is running out. We have logs. So you can do a bit more. I may be upgrading these houses soon. As soon as possible. As soon as I can. Into stone houses. They are just wooden ones now. But having a stone house means it uses less firewood, and the firewood will be really important in this playthrough. I have a bit too much people at the moment compared to my food production, so the next year has to be fairly good. Well, having the fishery now there is gonna produce at least a bit food. Having these guys live next to it, it's gonna help a bit. Need a toolsmith, definitely. I'm gonna take a couple people away from somewhere, I don't know where. Some of these 16 children need to grow up. So I actually have workers everywhere. Like, I need one more hunter. I could use a couple more fishers. And stuff like that. I also need a storage barn somewhere here. I don't think I'm gonna have it here. I mean, cannot have it here because it doesn't fit. Just barely. Yeah. So, it kinda has to be here, I guess. Sure, Chesney knows it. I will be streaming at least five more hours today, I think. If I get this achievement early on, I'll just try some other achievements. I think I'll build a hunter somewhere here, because these deer are just tempting me to shoot them. And doing the another hunter would mean I would get more leather, and I do need a leather or two for the tailor, so we get actually the clothing, and we are already ran out of clothing. We are also running out of food stocks, so the spring has to come soon. Actually, yeah. Let's get another fisherman, and let's take it from the herbalist, and have another hunter also. Or maybe another fisherman, actually. I really need these guys providing some food when it's snow season. So these guys should now start planting pumpkins and potatoes. More children. Not good. Stop breeding. And start working, you damn children. I think I'll just try to survive with the buildings I have now, because I don't have manpower to run everything at full efficiency anyways at the moment. And I should be fine with the food when everything is running well enough. I hope this fishery actually does a decent amount of fishing. It's kinda bad. This is the radius from the fishing dock, and you wanna have as much of this area in water, and it's only kinda having this bit there and this river, so it's less than 50%. I think you should have at least 60 or more in the water if possible. It's really difficult. Something like there would be an amazing spot for a fishery, so you would get this whole area from here and have like a small area here only, not being fished. So it would produce the maximum amount. Also, I want to get there as soon as possible, but having only this small corridor in there probably means I have to build a tunnel through the whole mountain, and it needs a shit ton of stone. Which is gonna be a really, really annoying thing about this map. Because it has no stone at all. I've almost used already everything that is easily available. So we might have to build a quarry soon. And quarries take a lot of space, which is not good. So I may have to not build buildings that are really resource heavy in the cost, especially in stone ones. And a tunnel through this is gonna cost, we can actually check, it's gonna be like 100 stone or something, if you're gonna even do it. Yeah, 100 is even close to what I was thinking. 208 stones, so that's probably more than I have in the whole map at the moment. So we are not gonna tunnel, it seems. Although a bridge here would be probably a good idea. And when this building is done, this house, I'll queue a bridge. Let's see, I'm actually gonna queue this building here. I'm gonna pause it, and I'm gonna make the bridge through there. Can't make it here? Oh, there. 40. It's cheaper here. It's actually cheaper there. So I'm trying to conserve my building materials also. So let's have it here. Yeah, this is 16 less wood and 4 less stone. Of course, it's not as efficient as the other road I mean, the other bridge would have been with. It's good. There's a bit of stone and iron there. And I can also get these from here. I may have to build a bridge there just to get the stone from there also. And this is probably gonna be my trading post location. Because trading post is also pretty large. And having it there would be a really good idea. I could have a... Actually, let's have this one here, and I could have a fishing next there. And a trading... and a storage barn in the middle. And a couple houses here. And maybe another fishery on this lake here. That would be a good idea, actually. I want to get the trading post going fairly quick. Because that allows me to trade for food and things. So I'll be having this woodcutter here, wherever it is, there. And maybe building another woodcutter next to it, down here. And having these guys produce as much firewood as possible. You're at the limit. Do more. Because firewood is really good for trading, and I'm gonna have my economy run on firewood, pretty much. And I'll trade as much as possible of that firewood for food, I think, and clothing and tools. Maybe not tools, I'm actually producing tools just fine. Have a nice dinner, Paizo. These guys are actually out of food. Yeah, this is the issue I'm having at the moment. The hunting cabin is actually doing pretty bad. And my crop fields are not doing anything at the moment because the harvest season is not yet. So it's gonna take a while before these do anything at all. Let's actually get these here. I know this is doing just fine now, so I don't really need to keep an eye on this. It's about 2,000 each year. It's only these I'm wondering at the moment. I actually have a couple children now who grew up into adulthood. So I'm gonna add one more fisherman, another hunter. Yep, that's how we'll do it. And you are out of leather, so we're gonna actually get both of these guys to do something else. Meanwhile, I would love to trade for sheep or cattle. Those would be really amazing things to have for additional clothing. Also, I want to build a hunter here because there is a lot of animals wandering around. Can almost fit it there. This would be so good place for the hunter. Maybe I have to put it there. Not so good anymore. Here maybe? This would be... Let's cue this here so I don't make something else there yet. And let's cue the other buildings also. Trading post there, and then we'll actually I was gonna have the fishery up there, so let's make the fishery first because I want to have it in the this bend for more coverage there, and next to that one I'll have the trade post. If it actually fits here. Just fine. And next to these ones I'll have a... storage barn. Actually, it should be closer to here. Have it there. Hey Dark, how's it going? Haven't seen you for a bit, actually. So it's good to see you. Everything is built. Let's